Clark's Creek Park. This is the Dead Man's Pond entrance. Went in this way once before, but not in 4K. I certainly wish I could do 4K at 60 frames per second, but I can't. Hey, certainly don't have the kind of money I'd need for that kind of camera. So. Yeah, Sony does not offer any good, decently priced, a 4K 60 cameras available that that don't overheat, that are a good price. So yeah, after I realized just how much different it looks between, you know, even though I only have a 1080p monitor, just how different it looks when I record in 1080p versus 4K. I mean, it's just a complete night and day difference. It's as if Sony's 1080p mode isn't really 1080p. It's like, what, 990p? And then they stretch it. So there's never anything pixel per pixel clear, or even anything remotely close to that. So I usually default to 4K on this camera now. Now, there's the Puyallup Loop Trail that goes through a lot of these areas, and I want to try that way instead. I really wanted to find a map of the other trails when I go the other way, but I can't find anything. Just find things showing the main, what they consider the main trails. So I'm like, well, okay. Well, let's try that. You know? If I keep walking, I'll run into the, big green water tower. But that's not where we're going. We're going this way. Anamorphic lenses are coming down in price. Basically, that's where you can film in true widescreen and you get the appropriate flares and such. But what they still don't have is a like wider angle ones. I think 25 I think might be the widest, 25 millimeter. And then when they do get a wide one, it'll probably be expensive, and I'll never be too expensive even to save up to get, you know? Hello. Cute dog. Man, if you've ever been lens pricing, if you go for anything other than manual lenses, right? You go anything other than manual lenses and you're spending a pretty penny. All the lenses I've gotten have been manual. There's one that I got that's only, well, you know, you're not, this isn't, these aren't very helpful if I want to go back. Guess I have just as much of a chance of getting lost this time as before, so. Alright. That's a little frustrating. Yeah, how am I supposed to remember this? How's anyone supposed to remember this? Yeah. This is the reason I didn't want to go the other way. And the stupid maps they supply, oh, they just show a main thing. They don't show any of the intersecting ones or any of it. Nothing. Sorry, I shouldn't be upset when I'm on a... trying to make a more positive video, but damn it. It's a pretty park though, it's really beautiful. Way too many forks on this set of trails, way too many, and no documentation.
Mine.
People have taken their BMX bikes here. Okay, another split. All right, well, at least that one shows. All right. Seems kind of weird to go this way, but... All right. Those signs work as well. There were some back there that just didn't. Just like, yeah, how is someone supposed to maneuver that? We'll see later, right? Squirrel. Wow. Never be able to see that. All that down there goes there to help stop erosion of the land. I don't know. Oh. Okay. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, first time on this section of the trails.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty nice up here.
It is.
Yeah.
First I got confused with some of the signs for the main loop trail, but...
Yeah, I know sometimes they change them once in a while.
Yeah.
I don't know which way they're going, but it is a nice loop. It is really pretty.
You have a great day. Down and up. All right. So be it. Thank you.
Yeah, it's a long time.
Hello.
Some good stuff?
Yeah. Great. Yeah. It's the first time I've been on this section of the trails, so it's interesting.
Oh, yeah. It's a good one.
Hey, have a great day. Ooh. Probably take me a little bit to catch my breath a little better. Hello.
How you doing?
Good, how about you?
Good.
I'm sorry to delay you there a little bit.
You're alright. Not sure we're gonna make it up this anyway. How you doing, bud?
Hey, good. How about you?
Oh, not too bad.
You have a great day.
You too, bud.
More mine birds, huh? Yeah, that's another one of these signs that isn't very helpful. We just came from here, and if I needed to get back here... Yeah, I don't know. Hello.
Hello. Tell us how to do.
Here we go.
Thank you.
Hey, have a great day.
Thank you. Cody, no.
Hey there.
How you doing?
Good, how about you?
Good. Excuse us.
Oh, no worries. Have a great day.
You too.
Oh, Jesus, it's gonna... let's see what happens here. Alright, I got worried. It's like we're gonna go down, all the way down to the bottom and back up again, because I'm not down for that again. We'll have to see what happens, right? Alright, yeah, this looks alright. Shouldn't have brightened it that much at that moment, but that's all right. Now, I'm certainly not going to be walking the whole Puyallup Loop Trail place. Place. Well, it spans across the park and then some other places. It's about a 4 mile walk if you do take the whole thing. So I'm just going to be taking a very small sliver of that. Well, maybe not that small, but... Alright, I recognize this from... Yeah. I recognize that. I think I've been here when I was on the other... When I came from the other way. Didn't know... These areas would run into each other. I thought I recognized it, but I don't recognize this mud hole right here, so... Well, alright. I guess we keep going. I've got a section from a song that I guess I made up going through my head over and over again, and there's no way to really describe it. It's not even a very good song. And you see, here's a trail sign that doesn't say anything. It doesn't tell us where you are or anything, you know? But I guess it says we're on that trail still. I don't know. Still wish there was a trail map, you know. I certainly can't complain about the beauty that's here. Beauty, eh? Wonder where that goes. I mean, obviously it can only go into the ravine, but bicycle. Oh, no worries. Hello. Beautiful day. Lots of people out in the park today.
Yes. Always on a nice day.
Hey, have a great day.
Thank you. Oh, sorry about that. Thank you.
Oh, no worries.
Thank you.
No worries. And just for absolutely no reason, I think I thought of the word champions, and suddenly I was thinking of the parody of We Are the Champions, and it's We Are the Tampons for Our Girlfriends. Hello. Hey, have a great day. too much. Alright, I know where I'm at now, I believe. If I go this way, I think it may lead down to where they have this fish hatchery, if I'm not mistaken. But I'm gonna stop filming for just a moment to look at maps, just to make sure, because I'm pretty sure that's where I'm at, but I want to be sure. Raise your hand if you're sure, right? Yes, that does appear to be where I am, but I am taking note of some issues that I seem to be having with my knees. I haven't... this was more of a workout than I had originally anticipated, so I'm going to start heading back. But this has been kind of cool, so... And instead of going way up and way down that one section, I might just take one of the shortcuts to the roads and walk down the road. I don't know, my knees are not liking me right now. Especially my right knee. Because we are the knights who say knee. I think I'll be fine, but I just don't want to do too much and actually damage it, so. Now I've got some John Barry music from a little-known British production of Alice in Wonderland. 1972. They did some neat tricks with specially designed rooms and special camera equipment to make it look like she was getting bigger. It's quite ingenious what they did. But it was a sort of a pseudo-musical. It was weird. But the music was done by John Barry, one of my favorite soundtrack artists, who died over the last few years, and barely a word was said about it. Kind of depressed me a little bit. I wonder if when John Williams dies, I wonder what people will say to that. I mean, I think about how in Britain, or just in England, the UK, they celebrated the life of George Martin and the works of George Martin when he passed. It's all over the news. I think there was even a parade. Here in the States, a tiny blurb that they were having parades in the UK, right? I don't know, parades, that's not the right term, but you know what I mean. They made a big deal about his passing. They felt him to be a very important person, and I also wonder what will happen when Steven Spielberg passes. But yeah, John Barry wasn't that well known, but that soundtrack that he did to that Alice in Wonderland movie is iffy as the movie was. He certainly set the mood. I always love the moodiness that John Barry could create. He's one of the elements that made the movie The Black Hole feel so dark, besides the plot. It's got to be the most depressing and dark Disney movie ever made, The Black Hole. Now it's scientifically really just totally inaccurate, but at least so we think. But still, the whole plot of that movie, the whole thing, dark movie. Actually, one of my favorites. Good cult film. Wouldn't it be cool if there was a TV station that plays nothing but cult films, cult classics? Man, I'd probably have that on, like, I'd have it on that channel probably all the time. Wouldn't necessarily watch it all the time, but that's what I have the box set for if it was out there. And we got so many TV channels, and so many of them are all playing the same thing. I used to like NCIS, but overplayed. There's like three different channels that play them constantly. And how many times can these channels do Harry Potter marathons? Oh my God. hoping I didn't bite off more than I could chew on this trail. Man, my knee. This is really the only way back. Unless I walk the full loop. But no thanks. Of course, I'm probably going on the hilliest parts, but oh well. Should have been on top of that, but I wasn't. My knee isn't giving me as much problem now. That's nice. The particular song that's going through my head now is from that is I've never been this way before. Don't know whether anyone's uploaded it to YouTube or not, but John Barry. Barry. Close Encounters reference. I think John Barry's best work was on Moonraker. Look up Flight into Space, John Barry. I know you can find that one. Thank you. Well, all right. Alright, well, I'm going to check something here. Alright, well, that street doesn't go through, so I'll just continue going this way and just hope my knees are okay, so. Yeah, if I went to the street, in order to get back to the other section, I'd have to go through someone's private property. And it's like, no, that's all right. Like, walk down the side of someone's yard. No. Not gonna do that. I'm just still looking over there because you can see the street over there, and if I can get over to that, I mean, I don't know. I'm just gonna do this. Can't see that very well, can you? There. Ow. Amazes me, mountain bikers will just ride right over this. They'll just do-do-do, so really? Hello.
Thank you.
Oh, no problem. Have a great day.
Thanks, you too. It's hard not to in this weather.
Yeah. Here I am complaining about my knee. And here's to hoping these signs are right. Well, in just a moment. Yeah, this shows... This sign shows as being, you know, this direction, but is that really the right way? Only the shadow knows, right? Well, let's hope.
It's annoying.
Hello.
Go ahead.
Oh, thanks. Have a great day. All right, it was the right way. All right. Well, that's good. Man, am I worn out. I'll have to do this a lot, because I need it. And I feel fortunate that I'm even able to do this. There's so many people who are not physically able to do it, so... I need to count my blessings. If you do end up finding the song I've Never Been This Way Before by John Barry, try for the instrumental version, not the version with her singing. Because it's just standard, you know, there's nothing particularly noteworthy about the singer, so it sounds better as an instrumental. Yeah, it was more info on that version of Alice's Adventures in Wonderland is it's Fiona Fullerton playing Alice. Yeah, 1972. Well, the signs seem to be working so far. Maybe it was my imagination, or just, I don't know, but we'll see. We'll see coming ahead, because there are some spots I don't remember them having consistent signage, but I could be totally wrong. And the signs are working. So that sign got broken, but it still shows this way. That's why I didn't. Alright, so it's vandalism. Look out, everyone. Tarianism. Tarianism. All right. Won't be long now, right? Hmm. Well, my battery is at 3%. So, 2%. Well, I'm almost done with the walk as it is, so it'll cut off at some point here shortly. I wonder how long this walk was. Hour 45 minutes, something like that. Well, just in case something happened to the file while it was recording, I wanted to save the file. So then it'll be any moment now and it's gonna cut off. So in the meantime, thanks for watching. And we'll see how long this goes.